International Students for Life, presented by Wise Words Media. You're listening to The Bloke Who Walks, and it's the Spotlight Series. And this week we're shining a spotlight on your first week in Melbourne. So say g'day to Melbourne, and congratulations, you've made it back. You're enrolled, you've got through your orientation week, and so have we. So a quick intro, about 30 to 40 seconds, to let you know what's coming up in this episode. You're going to hear the same intro throughout next week, and we're going to run through every morning for this second, third week for some of you of your first semester back in Australia. We're going to run through what should you be looking at, or what should you be considering in your first week in Melbourne. So you'll see won't pack too much information on the screen for you. We'll keep it as short and sharp as possible. So we're going to take a short break, enjoy the sights, sounds, summer, orientation week in Melbourne, Australia. Don't go away, we'll be right back. G'day, welcome back to this International Student Life. Really appreciate you dropping in to patronise this episode today. And guess what? It's the Spotlight Series. We're shining a spotlight on your first week in Melbourne. So say g'day to Melbourne. And today, say g'day to your local bank. Visit a branch in person is always a good idea. Have you set up your bank account yet? Well, maybe you should. It's easy to do, it's digital, but you do need to satisfy certain identity requirements. So we won't be going through all those here today. Go to your international student support team if you've got any questions or any queries, or you're not quite sure. But don't be afraid to go straight to the bank yourself, because the staff are there. They're only too happy to help you, and guess what? They're just like your international student support team. They're paid to help you, they're paid to serve you, so don't be afraid to go in and ask questions. The other important thing about having bank accounts, and probably this should be the first item on your list, they're vital for getting paid if you're planning to work in Australia, paying your rent and managing your expenses. And of course, all these things can be done online through your smartphone, your iPhone, your iPad. I don't know what you're going to be using, but you name it, every device can access Australian digital banking services. But also, it doesn't hurt to go into the branch to get a feel for how retail banking services work in Australia. These topics we've put together, we'll be putting out a short episode each day of this week, and then we'll combine them all into one longer episode for the following week. And these are just suggestions that we've been researching through all the material available in the public domain, especially from all the different universities. We are an honest broker of information. We're not paid by any university, any government body. We're purely independent, so you can take it from us. These are some tips that we've picked up in the international student education sector in Melbourne, Australia. So, but again, if you need any help and if you want any really good advice, go to the experts, your international student support team at your university.
And we are absolutely delighted to be with you tonight for this very special Queen Victoria Market Night Market, which is all about welcoming our international students. Students over the last 3 years, and we've also been so grateful to those who stayed for persisting and showing so much resilience. Our latest stats show that there are 138,000 international students back in Victoria, which is 92% of pre-pandemic levels. Woo-hoo! Because international students aren't just valuable on our campus, campuses and in our tertiary institutions. They're fantastic customers and consumers. They're wonderful participants and volunteers. They're incredible workers in our local businesses particularly, and this is about setting up relationships for the long term. If you are an international student, could you please put your hand up?
Volunteers to compete.
That's all we have for you now in this episode. We've somehow managed to fit all the information in. The other thing I would like to say and just remind you is that this channel is, we are based in Melbourne, Australia. We have, Wise Words Media has a lot of experience in international student education, creating marketing, video and audio content for international students. We also have a lot of experience settling people from overseas into life in Melbourne since 1979. We love showing off Melbourne and we love helping people get familiar with everything this city has to offer. So make sure that you make the fullest of everything life in Melbourne has to offer through your university. Your international student support team has many activities throughout the year, not just orientation week. There's many things to take advantage of, many clubs and societies. And if you're a student whose language, English, is a second language, don't stop yourself and be anxious about joining in. Get involved, practice your English, find conversation clubs, and we'll wrap it up there. You've been listening to This International Student Life. We're based in Melbourne, Australia, and we want to thank you for joining us in this episode, and make sure that you subscribe, hit the notification bell. You don't have to pay anything. It's free to listen, free to watch, and we'll see you in the next episode. Bye for now. International student offices or an international education recruitment agent in your country. This international student life is produced by Wise Words Media and Calumny Films. We accept no responsibility for any errors or omission of information in this video.